those voices? Where am I? I know this place. I've been here before. I've been here my entire life. I'm trapped in here. These stairs. I'm climbing these stairs again. I need to get out. The voices are calling me. Music box. It's broken. I have to fix my old music box. I have to get it. I have to... Those horrible dreams again. I've had them repeatedly ever since my mother died and left me that music box in her will. Harry always said that old family heirloom had something to do with my family's strange disease. If the doctors won't give us an answer about your illness, I'll search for one myself, you said. And in that search, it seems you lost yourself. I don't think I'd ever...
Pardon me, madam, but the island is in sight. We'll be lowering the boat in just a minute.
Oh, thank you so much, Captain Hodgson. I'll be right out. All right. Time to gather my things. I'd always dreamed of traveling. Though it's not the same without you, Harry. I think I've overpacked. Captain Hodgson has a very particular taste when it comes to decor. Not exactly a clawfoot tub, but you can't always get what you want. It's a relief that I don't need it to walk anymore. Oh, I'd better cover up my hands before I leave the cabin. I wouldn't want anyone thinking I'm a circus freak. I received a mysterious package at my house. I stored all its contents in my locked suitcase. I love this song. Oh my, I have the worst memory. I forgot the combination again. Thank goodness I always bring my journal with me to write things down. The amazing adventures of Nora Everhart, art teacher. Right, now it's open. Harry Everhart, my husband, my partner, and my dear old pal. A brass key with the letters CW engraved on it, and some enigmatic instructions. This strange and sharp relic came in the package I received at home. I saw this island in one of my unsettling dreams. I drew it as soon as I woke up.
We're all set, madam. Your motorboat is ready.
I'm definitely going to miss this bed. Falling asleep to the ship's rocking was delightful. Okay, Nora. From here on out, you're on your own.
Lower the motorboat and be careful with Mrs. Everhart's equipment, lads. We'll be back to pick you up in 3 days. I really hope you find your husband there, madam.
I hope it too. I'll see you in 3 days then.
Now please be careful on that island. You know what the legends say about it.
I'll take care. Thank you, Captain Hudson. Well, here I am, in the middle of the ocean after traveling across half the world. Just miles away from where my husband is supposed to be. You left a year ago to search for a cure for my affliction. Your letters kept me close to you, but suddenly they stopped coming. What happened, Opal? What did you find? Whatever it was, it led you to hire a crew and set sail from San Francisco to Tahiti. And from there, to this place. An island in the middle of the Pacific that the locals refuse to even name. Everything is familiar. So familiar. As impossible as that may sound. Is this the island I dreamed about? This can't be a coincidence. Breathtaking, idyllic island, surrounded by deadly reefs and protected with stakes to keep anybody from entering. Why? There's definitely something strange about this place. Okay, Harry. Let's see if I can find any trace of you around here. I'll leave my things in the boat until I find somewhere to camp. A tent. So somebody was on this island recently. A miniature va'a, a Polynesian outrigger canoe. Beautifully crafted, too. That's a vivo, a flute that the Polynesians play with their nose. I won't be playing that. A note written in French. I only understand two words, île and mort, island and death. It must be a warning about the dangers of the island. This machete is completely worn down. The blade is dull. Someone has been chopping down palm trees. A lot of them. Maybe to build something. I feel quite good. I dare say I might even walk a little faster than usual. Those markings seem to represent the sea. I'll make a note of them in my journal. It might come in handy. Looks like it opens from the other side. These wooden figures are called Unu. This seems to be telling a story. Bone fish hook. It may look peaceful, but clearly somebody wants to keep outsiders off this island. A lovely flower offering. From what I've read, the Polynesians don't need doors. So why build such a big one? Something's missing here. What? Someone carved my name in the back of this Unu. This box. CW. Those are the initials on the brass key. It opens it. So whoever sent me this key was here. This is starting to look like a scavenger hunt. A carving tool. Well, look what's hidden here. This may be the first time I trespass a private property. My childhood in Newburyport wasn't exactly the most thrilling thing. Is that... Harry? Harry, you were here!
You were here and I found you, dammit. Where are you now? Where is everybody? Where did you and all your crew go? Lady Shannon? That name sounds familiar. I'd better check my journal. This reminds me of those slot machines that Harry and I saw at the Atlantic City Pier. The Polynesian version. Oh, it's been years since I took such a long walk. This fresh air is doing me wonders. I can feel the air is denser here in this mangrove swamp. Rays of sunlight shining through. Another symbol. I thought Colorado was too far from home when we moved there. Now that I've crossed half the world, I wouldn't mind crossing the other half. But I have to do it with you, old pal. This sort of pond is a Polynesian fishing technique. There's another symbol inside it. My, this is so beautiful. What were these birds called? Lorikeets. Cole's lorikeets. There are lorikeet feathers scattered around this umu. I'll draw the symbol in my journal. A shortcut. That's convenient. This looks like cargo from an earlier voyage, long before Harry's expedition. What a beautiful mountainous landscape. flight ticket across the river, then. I've been walking. I've lost track of the time. Wow, what is this place? I'd better have a look around this abandoned village. Harry's crew might have stayed here. Stone slab looks like a mechanism to get up to the outcrop. Tiki, like something straight out of an adventure novel. The Everhart expedition. They set up camp here. Fascinating. Looks like some of the crew members didn't get along too well. A forbidden ritual?
Let me record it. So, you said you've been on this island before?
Yes. Some years ago. I made a rookie mistake. I detoured from my fishing boat to go to what looked like a better spot, less than an hour had gone. But when suddenly, my va'a, my canoe overturned. And I got this lovely souvenir from that mistake.
Heavens, what gave you that scar?
Not a what, but a who. I don't know. I didn't get a good look at it. But it seemed like a sea creature I never seen. Anyway, I was lucky enough to reach that whitened beach. The one where we landed on the island. A man came 3 days later and got me out of there. He brought me to the port of Otaheite without speaking a single word. Time passed. And I promised myself that I would go on with my life and forget about this damn island.
Why did you agree to return to the island, then?
I need to know what happened to me, to discover the truth. I don't know if you get me.
Absolutely.
So now you believe in magic, old pal? Polynesian man covered in tattoos. I'm not sure if he looks angry or scared. Well, what well? It's some sort of Polynesian coat of arms. Is that an octopus? Something's missing inside that emblem. these Tikis be some sort of guardians? They're composed of four pieces. It's broken, but I might as well draw what I can see of it in my journal. They were packing a lot of heat when they came to this island, but they took all the guns with them. Very neat. Quite a looker. A fashion model, maybe. His real name was Costas? Nice comb. Who worries this much about their appearance in a place like this? I'm not sure what to expect on this island, but I hope I won't regret not having a gun. I've never cared much for games of chance. Blowing an ancient hatch with dynamite sounds like a fool's errand to me. Ooh, looks like someone didn't like you very much, Harry. This fella sounds pretty hot-headed. Oh, damn it. Someone on the expedition died. Farewell message from a friend. Explosives. Looks dangerous. Did they use all the dynamite? What a delicate piece of craftsmanship. He seems confused, as if he was having a hard time writing this down. Close to a grave since my mother's burial. Shortly after she died, my lovely Dalmatian spots, as Harry used to call them, appeared. I thought it was nothing at first. Why is this hammock so far from the rest of the campsite? Little fellow. An amulet with a carved Marquesian cross. The symbol represents balance and protection. The river cuts through that canyon. It doesn't look safe to cross. must have found the luxury huts pretty swanky. I've seen Harry keep even restaurant checks for bookkeeping. He would never tear up a piece of valuable information. Got it. It's been whipped out of something else. Look at him, giddy as a schoolboy. Ichor? That Frank seems to feel guilty for whatever happened. I feel really bad for him. Considering how poorly Harry draws, this isn't half bad. Maud? Interesting. Did you get into, Harry? You put together quite an expedition, Harry. And all just for little old me.
My dear old pal, I know you won't ever read this letter, but I'm accustomed to writing you, and it comforts me in this strange place. This island is riddled with secrets. So many secrets. But I'm not only talking about mechanisms and contraptions, Nora. I dare say that something on the island clouds one's judgment. Otherwise, I don't have an explanation for Roy's actions. The man was arrogant, impulsive, and a little cocky, but he was no fool. We weren't friends by any means, but he didn't deserve what happened. We may have made some progress in finding the cure for your illness, but at what price? I miss you so much, Nora. Harry.
He may not say it explicitly, but Harry blames himself for Roy's death. I know him too well. And I miss you too, Harry. This explains why the campsite is nearly abandoned. Other planes of existence. That's bats. The Harry Everhart I know would never have given up on this. Something must have happened that kept him from solving it. Black ooze? In a telescope? Where did you get this strange device, Harry? not really sure how this thingamajig works, or what to do with it. Jeepers! A stranded ship! Something's missing here. Parts of the Tiki on this column seem movable. Secret compartment. This appears to be the shrine of a Polynesian chieftain. What kind of stone is this? I've never seen any substance quite like it. It feels disturbing. Hated asking his parents for money to fund this expedition. The Everharts are a wealthy Boston family, quite old-fashioned. They were never really pleased with his eldest marrying a middle-class girl. That's why he wanted to get away from them as soon as he could, just like his siblings did after him. How is that possible? What fascinating technology. Oh my! Oh my goodness, what happened here? Better not touch it. But given what happened, they shouldn't have either. Is this stone structure a hatch of some sort? Black ooze again. Skin alterations. Like the ones on my hands. pipes. This man was splashed with that black liquid. Whoever took this picture must have a really cool head. Those spots look all too familiar. Is this a picture of my hand? Heavens, he's losing his mind. Erythrocytes. Aren't those red blood cells? Ugh, I can't stand the smell of medical equipment. Reminds me of my illness. Well then, I'm going down. Come on, Nora. Deep breath. Is somebody whispering? Hello? Is anyone down here? This eye, is it calling to me? Were these eyes related to the ritual? Do they have two pupils? Another eye. I hear whispering. I almost feel as if they're watching me. I can press these star-shaped tiles. Maybe he heard the whispers too. Well, this looks like another job by Handyman Harry. You were close to something here, Harry. Let me see if I can solve it. Well, that was, it should save some time. I think I solved it.
I wonder what I might be able to see with this lens. It fits. What? What on earth? What is happening? My God. What? What was that that I saw? What were those stars? Right, looks like I solved it.
Great Scott! The well is filling up. That's black ooze. No. It's happening. I'm feeling faint. I can't stay on my.
What is this? Where am I? Am I dreaming again? This is different. It isn't my recurring dream. I can't stop walking. My legs aren't responding. Holy Moses, what is that creature on the horizon? Wait a moment, No! Underwater. I have to get back. I have to find. What is that? What kind of creature is this?
This speech. Oh, I have a terrible headache. torn apart and cast so far up the beach. What on earth could have happened to it? I'm terrified. I've always been afraid of storms, but something or someone seems to be moving there on the reefs. Or is it just my imagination? Could be seen beyond these shores. Looks like they took items from the stranded ship. I believe Harry visited this exposition when he was looking for answers for my illness. I believe Harry visited this exposition when he was looking for answers for my illness. It's too dark to see anything inside the tents. I should find a way to turn these lights on. Photographic film. A portable typewriter. A pulp magazine. I love Chandra Hogarth stories. Face. Is this what's going to happen to me? Those footprints definitely do not look human. Is taken from a distance. What is he doing? Floating rocks?
someone here had a green thumb.
He's repairing my old music box. Attack? What attack? What happened on this ship? Did he take some amulets from another campsite? Or did he carve some more? Someone took notes about some important dates.
These two fellas seem to get along pretty well.
I'm glad you stayed by his side, whoever you are. These medical tools are hair-raising. The doctor was certainly well supplied with all kinds of substances. Oh dear, this doc was a certifiable loon. A white fedora. It's really dirty. A handkerchief with the letters EDW embroidered on it. It's stained with blood and black ooze. Discarded clothing. It hasn't been worn in a long time. My God! The ship's hull was ripped open. A few jagged rocks couldn't have caused a gash of this size. Oh, this place gives me the creeps. See any trace of the ship's crew, nor their remains. Dead as a doornail. This isn't right. Damn it. Nope, wrong. I'll try again. Voice.
It is a distress call from the Everhart expedition. 74 nautical miles east of Tiki.
Is that
the lady
Harry?
Is on the ground. Its crew is unaccounted for. So five
no.
Of us have survived.
Just a recording.
We're stranded on this island. Please send help immediately.
What were you looking for in the heart of the island? Frank is certainly a resourceful man. Even the crew of the ship that brought Harry's expedition to this island were afraid of it. This is the captain's last entry. The ship was whaling not far from here. Maybe the legend is more real than it seems. These knobs must control the vibrations inside this chamber. Ooze's properties are perplexing. And I was completely covered in that black goo. I wonder what it'll do to me. Only God knows how long I've been covered in this black liquid. I wonder what it's going to do to me. Although I doubt anything could be worse than my illness. Menu is rather limited here. I don't know if someone in the expedition was a cook, but I really hope they didn't rely on Harry for it. When he lived in the dorm.
The expedition only has 5 members now.
some kind of improvised workshop. This must be the highest part of the island. And that diamond shape again. How striking. So this is the reason the ship was scavenged. What kind of machine were you building? Blowtorch. Looks like it's been used a lot. Harry isn't usually very chummy, but he really seems to like Frank. Photo. I can't make out what's in it. When I get back home, I'm going to read up on engineering. I've been interested in knowing how things work since I was a child, but I always thought technology wasn't for me. What nonsense. Huge stone door looks like an exit. How does it open? This ornate structure certainly isn't natural, but not man-made either. This feels ominous. Must be instructions to operate this bizarre structure. Those symbols seem to indicate the height of the tide. Quite scared of storms. When I was a child, I used to cover myself with the sheets to not listen to the noise of thunder. I honestly doubt I'd like to cover myself with anything in here. Time to overcome my fears, I guess. There are strange marks on the wooden pole. Never heard of this Eric Zan fella. It might need to be turned on. It might need to be turned on. What kind of doodad is this? Look at the size of these stones. These symbols are linked to the piano keys. How can someone build something like this out of stone? You always did have a good ear, Harry. Sometimes I still doubt whether this isn't just some ghastly dream. It's curious, but it's the first time since I got sick that I feel useful. Harry is depending on me, and not the other way around. Odd structure. It doesn't look like a building, though. I hope you didn't borrow this slide projector from the University of Denver, old pal. I think this is the right one. It's well-tuned. I expected no less from you, old pal.
better write down those numbers in my journal.
Dear old pal, I think I'm getting closer to understanding what is happening to you, but it is taking a toll on my sanity. As fascinating as this island and its ancient and unfathomable wonders may seem, it's also a place plagued with misfortune and calamities.
We lost Roy at the campsite. We almost lost our engineer on this beach. The doctor went mad and stabbed him with a strange knife.
And all because of this island, Nora. Initially, we were optimistic and in high spirits, but now we've all become resentful and discouraged. Even I can feel how I am constantly assaulted by dark thoughts.
Anyway,
if what I am going through here helps me find you a cure, it'll have been worth it. I hope to find an answer in the temple on that mountain peak. Love you always, Harry.
He is worried, exhausted, disheartened. I will find you, my love. Let's see what the next one does. Dangerous. Maybe it's because I haven't spent as much time here as Harry did.
Whew, that was quite a hike. I've been seeing these horseshoe-shaped pillars all the way up. Do they mark a path? I'm at the top of the mountain. I can see that giant diamond-shaped thing really close from here. Took me a while to get here, but the views are worth it. These drops of rain are so refreshing. Feels really good. Heavens, looks like a rock slide crushed all the tents. All but one. Torn picture. Maybe the Polynesian guide didn't like people taking pictures of his scar. The only tent that came out of the rock slide in one piece is the one filled with amulets. They didn't accept Frank in the university. They should be ashamed. I'm not sure if Harry ever got to read this note. Oh, I'm sorry, but art has never been your thing, old pal. Are these figures singing like a choir? Built all this just with pieces from the beached ship. Frank sure must be a real whiz. No power. Nakal? So, this is like Atlantis, but in the Pacific Ocean, right? They built loudspeakers on top of this tower to reproduce the effect of the organ. Very clever, old pal. His low spirits are obvious in this photo. What was wrong with Frank? He looked so thin. Dead as a doornail. Harry's convinced the answer to my illness lies inside that temple. Looks like a sneaky snapshot. She doesn't look at all happy. Oh no! Frank died. Oh, Frank had a daughter named Evangeline. What a darling. I'm so sorry. He was such a talented man. And he seemed to be a good friend of Harry's. They built a turbine to generate electricity under the falling water. But the stream isn't close enough to the wheel. Bible. It must have belonged to Frank. He thought it was a flesh wound, but it kept getting worse. Blood-soaked rags. These levers connect those gears to direct the wheel's energy into the turbine. There are some sort of sound devices built around this amphitheater. 1212, testing. Nope, doesn't work. No power. So I guess you used the notes from the organ and they weren't the right ones. There's a symbol inside. Wow, this door looks thicker than any I've ever seen. Homemade loudspeakers, probably to amplify the sound. Homemade loudspeakers, probably to amplify the sound. I like singing so much. Harry and I often sang together. When my condition got worse, Harry thought it wasn't a good idea to make unnecessary efforts. And we stopped singing. I know it was just for my own good, but my illness caused our whole lives to revolve around it. These stone columns just vibrate. Amazing! The hatches are opening. Now the wheel is moving. That was easy. These buttons seem to adjust the amount of energy that goes through the turbine. That should give the turbine some energy. Great! I did it. Now everything should be powered. What? Did I do something wrong? Come on, work! Come on!
Yes!
Now what? What's happening this time? Where am I? I can feel the fever rising. Oh God, no. My illness. Is it coming back? Is this an ocean? An ocean that dried up. My cane. My bed. Another memory of my illness. How many times did I think I was going to die lying in this bed? But it won't be today. It won't be today, damn it. I'd better find some shade before I dry right up. The horseshoe-shaped pillar. And that diamond shape again. I can't take much more of this. I feel woozy. Is that a house? That's not a house. That's our house in Inglewood. Am I dreaming? Or am I just losing my mind? Harry? Are you home? I miss you so much, old pal. I am definitely losing my mind. I don't understand what is happening, Harry. Are you... Harry gave me this necklace after one of his scavenger hunts. The happiest day of my life. And one of... The Everhart twosome. What a duo. My mother's music box. Yet again. What a sweet melody. What was that? Another vivid dream? And my music box again, but it wasn't broken anymore. And what a catchy tune. I've lived more in these last 2 days than in the previous 6 years. With my illness, I'd forgotten about the kind of person I am. I might not be daring, but I am determined. Love gave me strength, but it also gave me something to lose. I haven't sung since I got sick, but let's give it a shot. To show. This feels like hallowed ground. A hole in the wall, probably caused by the rock slide. That must be the spot where they entered the temple. Are they bathing him in black ooze? His hands are changing, like in my dream. Those spots, they look like mine. Now he's some sort of man-fish? Fish of every size and shape. A giant fish head made of stone. This looks like the same kind of elevator that was in the campsite. These patterns look too familiar. She sounds worried for him, I think. Where is this taking me? Looks like I'm inside the giant fish head that I saw from below. I've seen this symbol in the mural several times. I guess it can be applied to both water and black ooze. This one was really hard to figure out. Good job, Harry. Well done, Harry. Boy, am I lucky that you did the hard part of figuring things out. I'm starting to understand this language. God's blood. Does this mean that... Is this related to me somehow, to my disease?
My dear old pal, Nora, I wish I could write something else, but a long time ago I promised you I would never lie to you. So here goes. There is no cure for your illness. What you carry in your blood is changing you, and it will keep changing you until it's done, whatever that means. There is nothing we can do to stop it. My dear old pal, my partner, the love of my life, I am so sorry. I've made so many mistakes. All those deaths because of me. Frank, DeWitt, Roy. All for nothing. Maybe Teaharo is right. Maybe we can return to the beach and build a raft to get back to Papiete. Maybe in less than a month, I could be back.
There's no cure?
But he didn't finish the letter. What did you do, Harry? Where are you? I know for sure that you didn't go back home, so what? What do I do now? Are you still on the island? I have to find you.
Well, this one was easy, I think. It's amazing how words and symbols can keep their meaning after thousands of years.
A complex pattern.
Harry marked this symbol for a reason. I'd better write it down.
This is the right combination. It appears Harry didn't advance any further. What is that thing? Is that the outline of a hand? Those are drums of some sort. Ceases to amaze. Harry said it didn't work for him, so it shouldn't work for me either. Unless there's something different about my hand. Anyway, Nora, you know what you've got to do. My hands! Look at my hands! This is definitely not a dream. And I'm starting to doubt the others were dreams, too. Scared, but it's hard to explain what I feel, but it isn't fear. Not a bit. Another one of those gates, like the one I saw in the temple. I'm back to being me. It's hard for me to understand how these gates work. What happens every time I cross one of them? Am I two people and just one person at the same time? I'm not sure if I'm changing or if the laws of physics and even reality itself bend slightly to my will.
another panel of this strange technology. What's it for? Something related to the currents? Island is pierced by underground currents. That architecture again. Where is this gate going to lead me now? What a quiet and peculiar place. Is that black blood the same thing as the black ooze? Looks like some sort of food. It's not human food, though, and it's fossilized, too. Marks. They look quite old. I wonder who used to live here. It seems it was abandoned ages ago.
We father, we mother.
I understood that. Slaves and masters and... Nicole, Wasn't Nicole in the notes? The inhabitants of this village lived at different altitudes. Some even lived inside the water. They used this sort of dam to lower or raise the water level. It seems that each family had to agree somehow to change the water level. I'm amazed at how organized they seem to be, despite them being so primitive. Being trapped here probably made them stronger as a community. Although they are the same style, these huts are much simpler than the magnificent architecture I've seen up to now. Whoever the inhabitants were, they were living here against their will. Someone vandalized this mural. Some hands look human. But others are amphibian hands. There are some hand marks made with pigments. I wonder if they mean something. I better draw them just in case. Black blood in eyes, like in the well. How can I explain what's happening to me? What is the meaning of all this? God's blood, transformation, eternal life. I feel like I'm going through what was written in that inscription. Water animal. Is that what I am now? This reminds me of some prehistoric cave paintings. Like in the Cueva de las Manos in South America.
This civilization used these devices to raise and lower the water level. It's impressive. So these creatures are immortal? The sunken continent. Was that their punishment? This underwater town is a beautiful place, but it has also seen a lot of suffering. All the island is that way. Beautiful, but dangerous. The danger does not seem to affect me, though.
my illness has kept me from being happy. What I feel now is the complete opposite of being sick. I feel full of life and energy. Even better than before my illness. Now the water level is really low, so I can access that tunnel. These creatures lived like slaves, all their lives imprisoned and tortured in this place. Was it possible to live a decent life in here? If you've lived all your life in a prison, how would you know that you are a prisoner? Now I can enter this tunnel. Is quite strong. I wonder where it will take me. Quite a ride, but it's over now. That ladder. Someone set up camp in here. What is this? This... Oh my god! Did I almost forget about Harry?
My dear old pal. It's only Cass and me now. I have much to thank her for, even if our friendship is worn thin due to hunger and fatigue. If she hadn't insisted so much, we'd never have convinced Heiroa. He guided us as we followed the river down from the mountain peak. And that's how we found this entrance. And the mural. Maybe I can't undo what's happening to you, Nora, but I think I can try to become like you. The original inhabitants of this island took slaves to a sanctuary, and there they performed a ritual. Teaharoa said the ritual was madness, and he didn't want any part of it. He and Cass argued violently. When we woke up the next morning, he had left. I know it sounds strange, but you have to trust me, my love. I know this is going to work, and we can be together. You understand what that means, don't you, Nora? We have a second chance. With more love than ever. Harry.
Harry? What ritual are you talking about? Why on earth would you want to become like me? Please don't be a fool. You don't even know if that ritual of yours is going to work. Somebody painted these symbols on the wall. You followed the river from the temple summit, and it took you some days to find this entrance. You followed the river from the temple summit, and it took you some days to find this...
A sanctuary? Harry, was that where you went? Dear, poor people. Is this why I'm changing too?
So the guide left the expedition. That would explain the workshop on the White Sand Beach, where I arrived. The sun is setting. It is so beautiful. This panel looks different from the others. It's much more elaborate.
Thank you.
This must be my transportation to the sanctuary. So this boat will take me to the sanctuary. Nothing bad is going to happen to me here, as menacing as this place might look. The island, the ooze, those sea creatures. They're just defending themselves, like a wild animal against an unknown threat. That's how they perceived the expedition, like a threat. But I, on the other hand, I wasn't a threat. And I definitely wasn't unknown, was I? They seem to recognize me, as if I was one of their own. Everything seems so distant now, as if I first stepped on that white beach thousands of years ago. A full moon? It can't be. Yesterday was a new moon. Did I lose track of time, or... Maybe this place isn't subject to the laws of physics. That's the only explanation I can find for this surreal night. It's hard to believe everything is real. Maybe it isn't. Maybe I'll open my eyes sometime and I'll be back in our home in Inglewood and... everything will be as before. My perfectly ordinary life with Harry. My daily routines. My illness. That will be as before, too. And then I'll need to shake off this strange feeling that I have now. Feeling that I don't really belong there anymore. And with there, I don't mean Englewood, or Boston, or Newburyport. I mean... How is it possible that the strange events of only 2 days on this island makes more sense to me than the life that I've been living for years? There it is. The sanctuary. So is this where you went, Harry? Was this your last stop? Another camp. Although it's little more than a few things scattered about.
My dear old pal. I never should have trusted Cass. I thought she cared about you, but she's just mad, obsessed with this place. I can't trust her to help me overcome the last obstacle. This door. I know how to open it. But what I have to do is mix my blood with the black ooze. Am I mad for even considering that?
It's the only way we can be together. It has to work, right? All this can't be a coincidence. The ritual is made for the two of us, isn't it, Nora? I wish you could be here to... Damn it. I have to think it over. I can't. Tomorrow. Leave it for tomorrow, damn it. Stop writing.
What are you saying, Harry? Don't you see what the black ooze does, what it did to the doctor? Are you out of your mind? A library? What are you talking about, Harry? Was the blood of these creatures some sort of catalyst? This dagger looks exactly like the one I have. These patterns look too familiar. I really hope this works. So I have to put my hand inside? Moby Dick. Its pages are hollowed out, and its shape is... Harry asleep in his tent. What a creepy photograph. Oh my, she sounds completely out of her mind. A camera. It must be Cassandra's. Let's give it a try. Looks like a tattoo, but it isn't. Those are my spots. They've moved. This mural seems to describe a ritual involving blood. A dagger. If he's behind that door, I wonder which Harry I'll find. How much would be left of the man I love? And how much of the man who has lost his sanity in this place? Different doors with different symbols. An eye and a star. Look at the stars, maybe. The stars are aligned, forming a constellation that I don't recognize. That is not the same sky you can see from Earth. And if that's not the Earth sky, where am I now? A shining constellation. I better draw it. Where is this door leading me? They carried these people here to test them, like a challenge of some sort. Pentagon-shaped symbol with channels in its edges. What was it used for? constellations and stars. These people seem to worship otherworldly gods. I wonder what this means. Those stone statues seem to rotate with this switch. I wonder what this means. All these papers are riddled with incoherent... Circular stones with strange carved symbols. These icons on the wheel are the same as the constellations I have on my hand. Took them to a throne room. That was the final step in the ritual. What an odd structure, riddled with nooks and crannies and endless stairways. Maybe it only hurts the first time. I hope this is worth it. When I arrived on this island, I felt like I was trespassing. But now, I feel like this is where I belong. This place is like a labyrinth. We were submerged in black ichor. Harry seems to be on the brink of madness. But I don't feel the slightest hint of confusion. On the contrary, I feel my mind is more focused than ever.
Again? Seriously?
Black and white figures. Good doggies. Or dragons, whatever you are. Come on. One more time.
Ow! That hurt!
Again. All the doors are open, but where is the constellation I need to open the throne room? Another one of those gates. I have to get into the water again. I can feel the torment of the thousands of slaves who perished here. Seriously? sanctuary's open. It's time to find out what's waiting for me inside. Not to disturb a mirror. Is it made of black ichor? I feel like it is speaking to me. Oh, heavens. There's something written in the floor with blood. Fhalgof'n? Haven't I heard that word in my dreams? Appears to respect the most basic rules of physics. However, as strange as it may be, it does maintain a peculiar harmony. Like the workings of a clock, or a music box. Wasn't going to work. That's why you never sat on the throne. You didn't even perform the ritual, did you, Harry? But you wanted me to think that you had. You even left a lure to confuse me. But why? What really happened? The only person with you in that sanctuary beach was Cassandra. So if you didn't die, it had to be her. Did she use the dagger to open the gates and carry out the ritual? You tried to stop her, but it was too late. She shot you with your own gun. And left you for dead, didn't she, Harry? Because Cassandra was ambitious, he would stop at nothing to uncover the secrets here. The island fueled that hunger for knowledge. Doubts about whether the ritual would work. But what happened to Cassandra cleared up those doubts. The ritual wasn't for people like you. The ritual was only for people like me. But you refused to believe it until the island itself spoke directly to you. Haha, Fhalgof'n. She is our daughter. That's when you finally understood. You understood what my fate would be if I didn't come here and carry out the ritual. A slow and painful death. So you faked your own death and left your glasses near Cassandra's corpse. Those same glasses you never take off. And you sent me the package from Dignity, Harry. Your picture, the key, the dagger. Another one of your scavenger hunts. And I took the bait. You made me come to this island, the same island where you almost lost your mind and your life. The same island where four members of your expedition perished. Why did you deceive me, Harry? You said you would never lie to me. Why didn't you tell me the truth? Why did you do this to me? Because you knew that I would never accept my fate if it meant leaving you. Right, my love? Not even if staying with you would mean a slow and painful death. So the only way to get me to leave you was to make me believe you were dead. And you chose to live a life without me, so I could be who I really am. That's why you tried to deceive me. But I know you too well, my dear old pal. We had so many years together, so many moments of love, happiness, understanding, friendship. Oh, beautiful life with you. I know what you tried to do, but I can't let you make this decision for me, Harry. Either I embrace my fate and accept what I've always been, and leave you behind. Or I reject it, and return home with you to relish the time that my illness gives us. It's my decision to make. You were right about one thing, Harry. I would never accept my fate if it meant leaving you. I know who I really am. And where I belong. I know fate has eternal life in store for me, but an eternal life without you is worthless, meaningless. So, I choose the slow and painful death. I'm going back home. You staged this ruse because you love me. But true love is reciprocal. So I'm also making this decision because I love you. Our love is greater than fate, lineage, or all the pain I can suffer. Whatever time we have left, we'll spend together. When the time comes, it will be your hand that holds mine. And those beautiful blue eyes will be the last thing I see before I leave.
You didn't find your husband on that island, Mrs. Everhart.
I did find my husband. He wasn't on the island, though.
But what have you been doing these 3 days, then? What did you find there?
I don't know. The truth about myself, I suppose. And at the same time, the reason to go back home.
I don't think I follow you.
Have you ever been in love, Captain Hodgson?
In love? You mean like in a romance novel?
No, that's fiction, Captain. In real life, true love stories don't end with a wedding. They end with a funeral. And the only thing that eases that final moment of heartbreaking sadness are all the good memories lived together.
Honestly, I don't think I've ever felt anything like that, Mrs. Everhart. But if you love your husband that much, he's certainly a lucky man.
We are both lucky.
Okay, are you ready?
Yes, I'm ready.
One, two, don't forget the harmony. One, two, three.
All my life is empty since I went away.
Skies don't seem to be so clear. May some angel sentry guard you while I stray, and fate be kind to join us some sweet day. Oh, how I miss you, dear old pal of mine. Each night and day I pray you're always mine. Sweet.
Just want you only, want you all the while. May God decree I have you back someday. Oh, how I miss you, dear old pal of mine. Each night you're always mine. Sweetheart, may God bless you.
Honey, are you all right?
I'm fine, Harry, don't worry. I can keep going.
No, listen, let's leave it for today. You shouldn't make any unnecessary efforts.
Really, darling, I'm fine.
You need to rest, Nora. Come on, I'll take you to bed.
Even today, so many years later, I still doubt whether I did the right thing. In the end, it didn't matter. You returned home and forgave my deception. We moved close to the sea and had a few more good years, didn't we? Until you left me that one sunny March morning. I wish I could be reunited with you. But fate has punished me with a long and sorrowful life, with no other incentive than my work. Because that is the only thing I have now, my dear old pal.
We had a really good life. But that's not my life anymore, is it, Harry? Not after what I've been through on this island. Not after all I've found out about myself. I can't fool myself anymore. I have to accept what I truly am, and leave you behind. I'm going back home. What a lovely melody. I don't believe I've ever heard more than a few notes. Until now. For years, I thought I was sick. But the truth is, I was homesick. My poor health, the pain, the suffering. It was all because of how far I was from here. Everything seems so far away now. No trace of pain, no trace of sickness. Nothing besides this place. It's so pleasant to forget everything else. Nothing matters anymore. I'm finally one of the thousands of minds connected to the I-Corps. Connected with the Elder God. Goodbye, Harry.
No.
Okay, are you ready?
Yes, I'm ready.
One, two, don't forget the harmony. One, two, three.
All my life is empty since I went away. Skies don't seem to be so clear. May some angel sentry guard you while I stray, and fate be kind to join us some sweet day. Oh, how I miss you, dear old pal of mine. Each night
sweet.
I love you, Nora.
And I love you, Harry.
Even today, so many years later, I still doubt whether I did the right thing. I lied to you for the first and last time. And even if it was to free you from pain, suffering, and death, I deceived you. But I've paid such a high price for my deceit, Nora. Fate has punished me with a long and sorrowful life, with no other incentive than my work. Because that is the only thing I have now, my dear old pal.